Good morning, everyone. I hope you had a nice evening. Hope you have a wonderful day. Last night at 9:40 p.m., their local time in Japan, there was a magnitude 6.3 earthquake off the coast of Izu Island, Japan. But according to the Japanese website, this page has been translated for you. It was a magnitude 6.6 with an intensity level of 2. Using Google Earth, here you can see Japan. This is the Izu Bonin Arch or Trench. And what is really surprising, because this is an area where two plates collide, the Pacific plate subducting underneath the Philippine sea plate. So you would expect maybe one plate to drop down, the other one to rise up. But that was not the case with this earthquake. We actually have spreading. Here you can see the one plate moving towards the west and dropping down. The other one also dropping down. And you'll see the moment tensor ball here. We got spreading. So for the plane fault zone 2, you can see here how the plates were locked before the earthquake. And then afterwards, yeah, we got spreading. Really unusual. Because of the subduction, we have over here towards the west a ring of volcanic activity. You know, it goes down and it comes back up the plate, creating this ring of islands. You can see here how the Pacific plate is moving west, the Philippine plate, going towards Japan. This is also an area of subduction, continents colliding. There was 4 felt reports sent in to EMSC. One said it was shaking for about 20 seconds. They were a long ways. They were northwest from where the earthquake occurred. So that would be a little more than 325 miles northwest. Another one, 543 kilometers, which would be about 337 miles, also northwest, said it was small shaking for a few seconds, barely noticeable. Tokyo, it says it shook for about 20 seconds. And another one, 559 miles northwest again. So that would be about 340 miles northwest. So there was slight shaking for less than a minute. Noticeable, but nothing rattled. Well, they are a long ways away. So for the depth, they have 10 kilometers, which would be about 6 miles below sea level. And they have 6.6 as the magnitude and intensity level of 2 on this page. And then they have the arrival of the earthquake at different stations. Let me bring it down for you. USGS has 36 people that reported to them that they felt the earthquake. They're saying it was 6.1 kilometers in depth, which would be about 4 miles below sea level. Well, they could be off in the location of where this earthquake occurred. When earthquakes occur out there in the ocean, it's actually kind of hard to triangulate where they happened at. You need 3 different monitors, you know, in the shape of a triangle to get the exact location. So anyways, yeah, it's unusual that they would have spreading there. What are your thoughts? Good thing it was so far offshore, and hopefully this is not a foreshock for something much larger, because as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for a much larger one to come later. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support. You guys know who you are. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.